Good morning. This is the Great Basin Fire Potential Briefing for Friday, July 31st. Fire potential impacts for today, hot and dry Friday, Saturday, Sunday through the entire area, the hottest and driest weather widespread throughout the region for the fire season so far. Another concern in this area, not quite critical, but above normal, 15 to 25 mile per hour winds, especially critical with the single digit humidity and the fact we have multiple fires in this area of southern Nevada and southwest Utah. Something to keep in mind. Some very isolated thunderstorms over the highest peaks, but not consequential so much for today. Looking at lightning yesterday, did have a handful of strikes in southern Idaho and a bit more up in the higher terrain. I'll have to see how the heat draws them out later today for new starts. Precipitation was fairly light with them. Here is our fire activity. New fire starts in the red, existing fires in the yellow, open circles indicating current ongoing large fires. Precipitation pretty bone dry the past 7 days. Maybe some wetness right along the Montana-Idaho border. Otherwise, definitely a dry trend for the region. Current fuel conditions, ERC-wise, we have the most critical areas. We see the red and dark red, even seeing some purples near record levels. Starting to modify here in parts of Idaho. We're starting to see 70th to 80th percentiles here, and that trend of drying fuels will continue quite rapidly over the coming days. Even on the live fuel moisture, you can see down here across parts of northwest Utah, we have values already down near 75, and west central Utah down near 55, near record dry levels in the sagebrush. So that's why the live fuel component is becoming part of the fire environment as well. This big high pressure ridge responsible for the heat pushing all the way up into central Canada, hot and dry everywhere here across the west. The monsoonal moisture, it's not there anymore, stolen by hurricanes from about 8 to 12 days ago, trying to replenish but taking a slow time doing so. There's our high pressure here on the left, hot and dry. You can see our fire potential on the right hand side, the driest areas to the south, but everyone will be drying out because of these low humidities here, single digits to low teens in most areas. Now here on the right is our concern for the wind. The dark green and orange shades are gusts between anywhere from 20 to 25 miles per hour, maybe approaching 30 in some of those areas. Again, there is current fire activity, and with those very dry humidities, any fires will take off quite rapidly. Hot day temperature-wise as well, 102 in Salt Lake, 101 towards Elko, 97 Reno, 104 up in Boise, 94 McCall, 112 down in Vegas. So everyone is hot. Not much change with the high pressure tomorrow. Notice more brown popping up here on our fire potential map on the right in southwest Idaho. Same single-digit humidity. Gusty winds again, I'll have to watch these down north of Vegas and in the Arizona Strip. These could be stronger if the models verify. This could be worth a high risk event. We'll have to wait and see on that. There's a high pressure ridge on Sunday. Again, that might change, hot and dry. More zones here on the right hand side drying out with that single digit to low teens humidity. Winds fairly light in just about all areas, starting to diminish, maybe a bit strong here along the Arizona-Utah border. No significant precipitation for us for that three-day period, and not much in the future as we see the high pressure slide off. We'll see a cold front coming through. We'll have to watch for some increasing winds in our northwestern areas. Otherwise, we start drying off quite rapidly. And you see by Wednesday on our right-hand side, all areas are in a bone-dry brown in our critical significant fire potential areas. And even though by day seven there's a weak ridge of a weak low pressure trough here approaching the coast, we're still close enough to the high pressure area where we will be near or above midsummer normals. That means hot and dry, and again, not much in the way of monsoon. This darker channel through here indicates that maybe an isolated storm or two could occur, but nothing too much. You can see those little green blips through here. Actually, that would be probably problematic for some lightning. There's a deeper monsoon by end of 7 days starting to get into southern Arizona, still a ways away from us. And on the 8 to 14 day, you see that below normal precipitation prediction that occurring near the Four Corners. That means from August 7th to the 13th, don't expect much at all in the way of any precipitation anywhere. We could see temperatures dropping back off to near normal. That is about the only issue. This concludes our briefing. Have a great day.